Have you ever spent way too long scrolling through Etsy or Teachers for Teachers looking for the perfect bulletin board letters, only to realize that nothing's exactly right for your theme or the colors that you want to do? That was me. 3 weeks before school started, sitting on my couch, coffee in hand, clicking through hundreds of thousands of listings, feeling that creeping panic. Then it hit me. I could just make my own letters in Canva. And honestly, it's one of those, why didn't I do this sooner? And if you ever wondered how to get that perfect white border, I round the letters so that they pop on any bulletin board. Make sure to stick around to the end because I'm going to share that at the end. It's my absolute new favorite obsession and trick. So let's start simple. First step, you are going to want to go over here to the Create button where you are going to pick a custom size. You want it to just be the size of your paper that you're going to print on. Next up, we're going to click on text. Make sure that when you're picking a text, it's big, bold, easy to read. We are going to start by first typing the letters M and W, because they'll fit nicely on our page and we know that the rest will too if those letters are correct. So you can see I'm gonna pick one of my favorite fonts, which is KA Honey Regular. You can, if you're on a premium profile, you can pick the font. So we're testing the W and the M, even though I don't need that. And then once I'm happy with the font, then I'm gonna type out the letters that I actually need for my display. Or you can also just type in the entire alphabet if you want to have the whole alphabet available. So, like I was saying, if you have a font that you can love and it's not in Canva, which has happened to me, this is one of my favorite fonts, you can actually go in and add any font. So you can upload your own fonts by going to the Brand Kit tab, upload, and then upload your font. And then from there, you can select the file from your computer, and then it's available for you to use in all of your designs in Canva. Personally, this one step completely opened up my options. Suddenly, I wasn't stuck choosing from the same fonts everyone else was using. I could match exactly what my classroom decor vibe was going for, and everything else that I had in it, those fonts that I had already used, could match. And that was exactly what I needed. Okay, so before we get too far into making our letters, a pro tip is that you can use a rectangle shape in Canva to check our letter heights. I'll just make a rectangle the exact size that I want the letters to be. Then I'll adjust all my letters to match. I like to make sure I do it in the very beginning, that first letter. This way, when I print them, they're all the same size and I don't have to go in and like change the formatting. So try and make sure you do that for your very first letter. That should be at the beginning, the first things that we're doing. Okay, so here's the part I promised you, my favorite white border trick. Once you have your letter size ready, we're gonna duplicate it and then we are gonna click and we are gonna actually change the color to this lighter gray because that's gonna be our little outline color. We are going to then click Effects. We're gonna choose Outline. And then we are going to change the thickness to 100. Then I like to go ahead, you're going to duplicate every letter that you need because this is going to be kind of like a layering project. And so it makes it easier to just go ahead and do one layer at a time. And then we're going to go in and we're going to copy and paste a letter on top, layer on top of that. So once I have all of my letters I need, I'm going to copy and paste it. From here, I'm going to change it to the color that I actually want the letter to be. I'm gonna go back to my effects and I'm gonna choose outline. We are going to actually put our outline as zero, as white, and I like it to be like around a 43. And then when you move it on top, then you can see that it's got that little gray cut line. From there, we're just gonna copy and paste it, and then we're gonna type in the letter so that we're not having to do those same steps every time. It makes it easier. All right, once I've got all those colors done, I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna add, I like to add this little black outline. So basically what you're gonna do is you're gonna copy, paste it. This time you're gonna pick hollow yet again. You're gonna change it to black. And then I like it to be about a 15 thickness. You're gonna put it centered right over your words. And this gives you that beautiful clean outline that makes our letters pop. This is great so that whether our bulletin board background is dark, busy, or even pattern like the one that I used here, I use the composition notebook vibes, it really makes our letters bright and easy to see. If you're making these types of letters with lots of layers, I was saying earlier, you just wanted to make sure that make the whole thing in one go through and add one layer on at a time, which is what you can see me doing. You will definitely thank me because this will save you time. All right, then once you're ready to print, you're gonna go up to the share button. You're gonna click download, change your file type to PDF print and download it. Now that it's a PDF, it's easy for you to just go in, open your PDF and click print, cut out your letters and you're ready to make your bulletin board. So that's how I went from endless font frustration to having exactly what I wanted for my classroom. Making your own bulletin board letters in Canva isn't just easy. It's actually kind of fun once you get to know these tricks. If you want to take this even further, I have another video that you can watch right here on how to do the same thing in PowerPoint, where I really like PowerPoint because you can even add things like patterns, textures, and images inside of the letters, and it just gives your font some really cool effects. And I will go ahead and link that for you to watch next. See you guys next time.